In December last year, the Finance Minister Matia Kasaija tabled before Parliament a 49.9 trillion national budget framework paper for the financial year 2023-2024. The budget framework comes at a time when the country is faced with challenges of high inflation and increasing public debt projected to reach 53% of the gross domestic product by June 2023. Addressing journalists today in Kampala on budget financing for the coming financial year, experts on budget matters from the Civil Society Budget Advocacy Group urged government to put more money in sectors which help people at grassroots level to improve their standards of living.
Our major concern is the wasteful expenditures. Mark the word wasteful. In government, we are aware there are so many areas where we are spending on, which we really don't need. And key is the duplications of functions.
They expressed concern that the current cost of running government operations, including wages, salaries, and interest payments, limit resources available for service delivery, which in the end affects the common man. They have asked government to accumulate local revenue through investing in sectors like agriculture, tourism, infrastructure, and human capital development. They also called upon government to reduce borrowing, especially on non-consensual loans.
The theme of this national budget framework paper, just to remind you, it talks about full monetization of the Ugandan economy through commercial agriculture, industrialization, expanding and broadening services, digital transformation, and market access. When you look at the budget framework paper, it's in agreement with the overall East African Community agenda of accelerating economic recovery and enhancing productive sectors for improved livelihoods.
The experts are concerned about the glaring gaps in implementing the lower secondary school curriculum. They want Parliament to direct reallocation of funding to the education sector.
Parliament should really directly reallocate funding within the education program to secure adequate financing for teacher training and securing the necessary equipment to support the smooth implementation of the lower secondary school curriculum. And when we talk about equipment, ladies and gentlemen, we are talking about even the basics like electricity in our schools, solar lighting. We are talking about the basics like having a gadget that can access GPS, GPS enabled. We are talking about the basics like training our teachers in how to use these e-systems. We are talking about the basics of sensitizing communities about enrolling their children in e-systems. So we are not asking for so much, but we are very appreciative of what has been done. We thank the government for the new curriculum.
Leaders have asked Parliament to save the country from government agencies duplicating duties. They're agitating that such agencies and ministries should be merged in a bid to save the taxpayers' money.
We have ministries, departments and agencies that are more or less doing the same work. Why would we have them on? And government is aware of this. That's why they came up with the rationalization of agencies, so that we reduce on the duplicated functions and we streamline government so that whatever resources is available is refocused on the key issues. That's where one of our concerns are cut.
Report compiled by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.